This is another video in Market Talk YouTube channel. So today it was a little late for me, as I mentioned last week also, because on the weekends a little tied up and I couldn't make the video on time. Okay, because today is weekend and I'm sure everybody will be spending late nights. Let us see what happened today in the market. So definitely I'm sure today Bank Nifty, if you made profit, I'm telling you, you are a very good trader, because personally I have not taken trades in Bank Nifty much in a personal account. Because of this, I expected some volatility, but I was concentrating the Nifty. Good that I'm not focusing on Bank Nifty much in the short side. But today was a fantastic day for trend riders of Bank Nifty actually. It's okay, but let us see what happened today in the market and what's the view and how far the Bank Nifty can go. I have made some analysis on Bank Nifty historical data also, and we'll see what happened on these things. So to start with, trading mantra for the day. So this is one thing I used to tell normally. I'm again telling you the mantra also today. If Bank Nifty or Nifty opens above the GAN midpoint, then 85% chance it will be bullish. And if Bank Nifty or Nifty opens below the midpoint, then it is bearish. 85% chance that it will stay below that only. Okay, only 15% chance it will reverse the trade, that opening above the midpoint and closing below the midpoint. Okay, so let us understand this midpoint means previous day high and low. So when you're trading today means previous day high and low average is the midpoint, simple. Okay, so this one thing I'm putting the key data also. So just take note, this one data opens above this midpoint means keep bullish, your view is bullish. Do back testing of yourself. I had done back testing for the last 2 years data, and this my analysis, 85% of time it will remain bullish if opens above the midpoint. Okay, so just keep in your subconscious mind this thing, automatically it will drive your trades automatically. Okay, let's move on to the Lakshman Director for September series. Now for September series, so this is the VWAP for Nifty for yesterday for September series, and today this is the VWAP, and the average is 11,622. So future price, this is a future price, everything is futures price. And for Bank Nifty, this is the VWAP yesterday and today, and this is the average. So sustaining below this is bearish, above this bullish, 23,908, and for Nifty 11,622. So let us see what will happen for Nifty and Bank Nifty for September series. What are the chances? We'll do some analysis also. But this is the Lakshman Tracker for September series. Once any closure below this only become bearish, till that time remain bullish in the Lakshman Tracker. Okay, so we'll see how much points we gained on the Lakshman Tracker also last week, and today another 1,000 points added actually above this. Let us move on to the FA data also. FA data was very interesting. That yesterday, if you see here, day for yesterday, they are holding 40,000 contracts. Today, yesterday 70,000, today 74,000. So they keep adding. So they are just driving the clients crazy. So they've been the clients. If you see here, they've been remaining bearish and adding future shorts on every rise for the past 6 days. 6 days they have been continuously bearish, and FAs are bullish and riding the market. I've been keep telling, remember, if you tell 2-3 days back that ADX is very low, around below 10 levels, then you have to be very, very cautious. Don't remain short in the Bank Nifty particularly. And same thing happened the last year also, before the election, the ride started. So Bank Nifty, now there is high chance that we can touch 25,500 also. We'll see what is the reason for that technically, and how this has happened for Nifty. Everything is technically driven. There is no view or some estimation or some guessing and all is there, everything driven by numbers. So let us see what happened in the power of 2 on charts, then we'll come back to the key data. So this is the power of 2 data. So power of 2, where we have 2 minutes chart, and for McGinley 20, McGinley 200, and this is a cloud also added actually for additional view. So today if you see, we have opened above midpoint, here we opened, and then the first 2 minutes we candle are closed around 23,736. And remained above the 20 McGinley only. If you see here, we never closed below the 20 McGinley, and then we went below this, and then once we crossed this, again we started moving up. So during the day, if you are not interested in this any other chart system, Euler Fisher or anything, you are confused, if you are not able to track so many things, just keep this one simple thing. If the price remains above the 20 McGinley, remain bullish. Okay, don't short. Simple thing. And if normally what happens here, if the crossover happens, 20 McGinley crosses below this 200 McGinley, then only you remain bearish. Okay, till the time overall view is bullish, and then internal view is bullish if the price remains above this 20 MIG only. Just keep the simple rule. Okay, here when it closes below this, then close your long positions. Okay, again if it close above, then remain long. Okay, just keep the simple rule. These two rules, like overall view is bullish because 20 MIG only is above 200 MIG only, and internally in the minor time frame also, this is your price is above the 20 MIG only. Okay, simple rule, keep it. I'm sure this will help you a lot, and this is above the long breakout also, and everything above the long breakout. I was not expecting this target to come in just one day itself. So around 24,000 it will fizzle out, I thought. Then it started to keep going on, like around 24,500 levels it went at. Okay, so I'm sure we'll see what happens in the Bank Nifty also near future. In case of Nifty, if you see here, the same thing happened. It opened above the midpoint and then above the long breakout it went. It tested below this and then again went above this. And the previous day high above this it went, and then it reached almost 11,683 levels. So here also same thing, if you see MIG only above it went, then went below this, then above it went above this MIG only 20, 11,606, then it went up to 11,680. Okay, so almost 80 points we got just following the simple rule. Once we go below this, then exit the long positions. If you want to go short also you can try, or you can go long also you can try. Okay, this way you just follow a simple rule, then definitely you will be able to make profits with a simple system. And forget this Hill Fisher if you are not interested, because some people are confused about how to use this. Sir, I am not able to use, because it will take time for you to get used to this, because in the smaller time frame it is different and the major time frame is different. This is how the power of 2 happened. Still we are in the buy mode only, because 20 MIG only is above 200 MIG only. Okay, so this is how the power of 2 happened in the Nifty and Bank Nifty. Let us go to the charts. First we will see the hourly view. So I've been keep telling in the last videos also, like this is the range I've been consolidating, almost how much, 11,372 and 11,087, almost 250 points range was there. So once we break this, it was expecting, it was giving a false impression that we will be doing a fake breakout, then it tested here, then I again started making. So we already achieved the technical target of 11,655 for Nifty. Once we broken this 11,380 level. Now the target is achieved. We have to see what is the further direction for Nifty, once whether we are able to sustain this or not. If you are able to sustain, then what is the target, we will see Fibonacci also. Now we will see for Bank Nifty in the hourly chart what is happening. This is the consolidation, like how Nifty we saw, this is the consolidation happening. The range is almost 2000 points. So the technical target for this breakout will be 25,500. So already we have done 1000 points. Another 1000 points is possible, but maybe it will do slowly, because it is becoming overbought and going above the Bollinger Bands. So possible that another 2-3 days it will do consolidation or some trapping. Another 1000 points rally in the coming 2-3 days maybe looks a little difficult, because call IV has become very very costly. Now call premium, if you want to buy call options, is very costly. So that is the reason that they will try to eat the premium in the call options. Then let us see in the daily time frame, what happened in the daily time frame. If you see Nifty, it is the Tenkan-Sen blue line, Kijun-Sen. If it is above this, so it is bullish, there is no doubt at all. And Ehlers Fisher also is bullish, there is no reversal look anything. Listen, then coming to Bank Nifty, here also same thing, we saw a very good breakout here. We saw the Tenkan-Sen crossing Kijun-Sen here, and then another 6 days continuous bullish move. Okay, so bears are taken for ride left, right, center. There is no way that bears could exit. The same thing I told you in the month of last year also, 2019 also, same thing happened. So there are not any chance at all given to bears to exit. If you see here, I told again also, I will just show you again. Okay, in the ADX I will show you, then you will remember. So when the ADX is giving a breakout above 10, then you have to be careful with the Bank Nifty. Let us see the second chart setup, Bollinger Band and Arun. So coming to the Bollinger Band, Nifty is in the top here and is not touching the 20 day moving average. It is you have to see any close below the previous day low for any weakness to come in the Nifty. Till the time all the bears are killed in the market and nobody is left out, then only the down move can come. Okay, if you see a high PE ratio is there, all problems are there, monitoring will complete, NPS will rise, so many news will be there, but still the market behaves irrationally and illogically for most of time. This is how market behaves. Arun indicator is not given any indication of any sell. Everything is in the buy mode only. And look for the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty, it has gone above the Bollinger band and very difficult to sustain at this level. I have made some analysis also. I will show you that why the Bank Nifty cannot sustain at this level, and it is very very less chance that it will be going above this for even 1% more on Monday. Okay, so 24,500 call, you should look for shorting if you are shorting call option, or you can buy put option also. So look for that low, whatever is there high for put options of Friday, for buying put options on Monday. Okay, and Arun has given a buy signal, so there is no weakness in Bank Nifty as of now. The any dip will be only correction only, because 20 moving average is support for Bank Nifty. Let us go to third setup. Third setup is the Heikin-Ashi. Heikin-Ashi is green candles, continuous 6 candles for Nifty, and even ADX is gaining strength now at 40 levels. So unless we see a triple super trend is breaking below this only, then weakness can come, otherwise it is bullish. So from all perspective, it is bullish only, no way it is a bearish, and the 11,200 is the support here. So any perspective, if you see here, Lakshman Draka is indicating around 11,600 levels is the support for September series. Anybody who is want to short also, think of anything in futures below Lakshman Draka, because that is the nearest support you have. Anything else, it is a little far only. Technically, you will get sell signal only around 11,200-300 levels. Okay, in case you want a near support, then only Lakshman Draka is the only one that is indicating in September series. You can get some short only below that level. So keep a close watch on the Lakshman Draka. Let us see the Bank Nifty. What happened in this Bank Nifty? We got a buy signal because other two super trend were in buy mode, but one was not in buy mode. That gave a buy signal around 22,600. After that, once that gave the buy signal, then we moved almost 1000 points. Okay, in the Heikin-Ashi. Let us see in the normal candle also. Here we got the buy signal around 23,000. 1500 points we gained after giving the breakout. So don't try to short now. Any dip is only for just you are going to short some intraday trades, otherwise it is in an overbought zone. If you see here, the ADX also has gone to how much now? 15 levels. Okay, so because once we start moving the Bank Nifty, it can reach up to 20 50 40 50 also levels. So ADX is once started shooting, it will make you crazy. So that's the way, you don't try to short Bank Nifty now. Anything down will be only correction only. Okay, because technically 25,500 we could be seeing target, because a lot of short covering is happening in the market. Clients are completely trapped with the shorts. Let us see the fourth setup. The fourth setup, 20 day moving average, 50 day moving average crossover. So this is the Reliance. So 20 day 50 day moving average crossover, bullish. Once we see any crossover below this, which is around 11,000 level, means it is very very low. So Lakshman Draka is the nearest one for you to any take any shots. Till the time, remain long only. It can go to Bank Nifty. I wanted to show you something also, like coming to Bank Nifty. So in case of Bank Nifty, there is a gap. Okay, just see the gap, how we got filled up in the Nifty. This is the gap. There is a gap here, which is in this area, 25,920, 20,000. So possible that Bank Nifty is coming towards to fill the gap. So okay, so be careful about this. And there is one more small gap also here. The low here is 28,125 and the high is 28,047. So there is small gap here, and 28,200 also. This also can come to get filled, because there is no way that the Bank Nifty will give chance for you to exit. If you are having a small loss, you should exit. Big loss, whatever, you should hedge it, because there is no point in fighting against the market. You will get enough chance if you are want to become bearish. You see, awesome indicator also is giving a bullish indicator. So now Bank Nifty is in the complete bullish mode. The breakout will see target 25,500 at least. Because any dip, all the bears who have been within the system will be trying to exit, because they also need some exiting time. So any dip will be used by bears to exit only. Instead of going long, so they will try to first exit, then they will go long. So it will be double power to go up on the upside also. So this is what for the chart setups for Nifty and Bank Nifty. Okay, and what else was there? Okay, and I want to show you something about the analysis also. Okay, let me just show you one analysis of a Bank Nifty, how much far it can go. So there is something 20 day moving average, everybody is aware. So how much 20 day moving average it can go above and below, above and below, we have made some analysis. So this data I have taken from 2009 onwards for Bank Nifty. So I have plotted the 20 day moving average from the beginning. So whenever it is above 10% and whatever is there, I just highlighted with the yellow color. Okay, so this is the analysis of what is the percentage deviation from the 20 day moving average. So within 0 to 5% it was almost like 1000 times, okay, 100 times, around 0% to between this 1000 times. Total data is almost 1 year plus data, 11 years data almost. And here if you see here, majority of times if you see this up to 5%, okay, up to 5% the total is coming to 87%, 87% of time it was ranging between the 5% minus and plus 5% from the 20 day moving average. Now we are 10% above, okay, now we crossed how much, we are 10.1% above the 20 day moving average. So how much times we have been there like this, 10 to 15%, and 5 to 10% is 275 times 10%, this is 5 to 10%, okay, and 10 to 15% of 38 times only. So only 1% of time in almost like 2875 trading days, only 30 days we stayed between 10% to 15%. So this is the internal breakup, how the breakup of 10%, the breakup between this between this range sustained for Bank Nifty. So if you see here, 0 to 2%, 1927 times is closing, actually closing basis, not high or low, closing basis, 67% of time it ranged between this time. And this is not negative, only positive above the 20 day moving average. If you see above 10% to 11%, 19 days. In the past 10 years, one decade, if we have seen the recession, recession is not there, 2009, from where the bull market started, to 19 days we stayed above 10% to 11% time, 1% of time. 11 to 12%, 8% of time. 8 days we remained above between 11 to 12% closed, and 12 to 13%, 2 days. So this is a rare case that we go about 10% above the 10 day moving and 20 day moving average. Okay, so what happened, like in case wherever we moved about 10%, how many days we moved, we can see the dates also. Let us see the dates, how much, when we moved actually. Greater than 1. Okay, now we'll see, this is what greater than 10% I have highlighted. So in the June we went about 10% in the June, and then before that in 2019 only once we went about 10%. We have, before that only in 2014 we went 5 years we never went about 10% at all. In 2014 several times we went almost like how many days, if you see here, 50, I'm not sure when it is, how many days, 3, 6, 7 times. Before 2013 3 times, 2012 2009 was a majority of times it went above 10% sustained, because after big recession, now also it's happening the same thing actually. After the big crash in 2000 March, beginning of the year, now we are seeing something like this. Okay, so now don't look for any shorting, any views from anybody about Bank Nifty bearish short means you have to be very, very cautious. If you are shorting Bank Nifty in futures means finished. Okay, don't do the mistake of touching the futures, particularly for Bank Nifty. Unless or else you are a very proficient trader, and definitely you be very cautious. Look for going for long straddles and at right time. Don't go blindly also, because there also the premium is very high, you get trapped. So go with the levels. So as I showed in the power of 2, above McGinley 20 you try to buy a call option and stay with it, and below McGinley 20 buy put option and stay. Do something like this. It is a very good technique which I just noticed today, how the McGinley also working on closely with the 20 day McGinley, okay, for Bank Nifty particularly. It is working very nicely. Try to implement this strategy. Before that, analyze your trades and how it is working. Do the past setups also. Do some back testing. Then you try this, okay. So because many of them, like one of few of the traders have been in touch with me, telling that, sir, you are giving so many strategies, I am very confused, which one to use. See, because you go to a marriage, okay, they will be giving you 3 varieties of sweets, savories, rice, so many items will be there, maybe 50 items will be there. it is not necessary that you should eat everything whatever they give. So you can be selective, and whichever you are comfortable, you understand. If you're not able to understand, just leave it. So I'm giving for, because there are so many varieties of traders in this channel, okay, subscribers and viewers. So whoever is liking that, maybe somebody is interested in Power of Two, somebody is interested in Awesome Oscillator, somebody is interested in Bollinger Band, somebody is in Super Trend. If you see better than what you have, go for it. Otherwise, stick to what you like and what your conventional, what your conviction is there. Just for a sector, you see whatever things you are seeing in the market or social media, you should adopt. If you want to buy some shirt, you go to a showroom where there are 20,000 varieties are there. You want to buy, say, 5 shirts only. You cannot buy all the shirts you liked, everything. Okay, you have to be selective. First, select something which you like. If you see better than that, you keep the one which is not better than that one. Keep it and go selective. You can be like, because there is no end to the selections. Because there are almost 350 indicators available in the market. So you have to be understanding which one is applicable for you, which is working for you, and which you are convinced. Okay, so there is no end to this. Let me just move on to the presentation. So hope you just understood what I told, the analysis. So that way, another one for monthly charts. In month, you just have to have a view on the monthly charts and have your view on whether how the market is going to behave in the medium to long term. So this is a monthly chart. What you do is you plot 20 moving average, simple moving average, nothing else. Every time when the price moves above the 20 moving average, it has to come and test the 20 moving average. Okay, it may take some time, but sometimes very rarely it takes long time actually. Just you see here, in case of Bank Nifty in 2009, when we went above recession, below recession, and then we crossed almost, we took 2 years to test the 20 moving average. Okay, so it takes some time, rarely, because after this big correction. Okay, so that way chances that we are going to test 27,000 levels also, 20 moving average in this current range, because we crossed above the previous day, previous month high also. Sorry, if you see Nifty, what is the status in Nifty? We already crossed 20 moving average. We tested 20 moving average in the monthly charts. So if you just see, we 1 month we crossed below this, and in 3-4 months we tested 20 moving average. It will not go super beyond this 20 moving average, and below this also too much below this. Okay, if you see, we mentioned about standard deviation also, same logic only. Just see Apple. Okay, you know, everybody knows Apple stock. See how it is behaving. So it went so much high, there is a high risk that it can correct from here to test 20 moving average, because it has gone double of 20 moving average. Rarely it can sustain here. Anytime the big crash can come in Nasdaq. So just wait for this, because you have to waiting, you have to wait for very patiently for something to emerge. Hope if you have not seen the movie called The Big Short, just try to see the movie. The guy, the hero, like how he has been waiting very patiently for the big crash to come. So that way, because you don't go beyond your levels to continuously hold your short positions expecting that the market will come crash. Because it can go slightly more also, maybe like it will take 1 month more also to crash. Nasdaq, once it start crashing, Dow Jones also need to do the same thing. If you see here Dow Jones, let us see what happened in the Dow Jones. Dow Jones, if you see here, it went below this, it's just now crossed above the 20 moving average and waiting to cross the 20 previous 52 week high. Okay, once we cross 52 week high, you have to see the Fibonacci and then how it is going to work out. Let me just try the Fibonacci also. Now in the daily chart, let us see the weekly chart. What is the Fibonacci telling you, where the target is there for Bank Nifty? In case of Bank Nifty, the weekly charts, okay, there is no relevance here because weekly charts will take time. The swing, how to plot the swing, the technique which I told you before, I'll just tell you once again. Try here zigzag. Try the indicator zigzag. It will automatically plot the zigzag indicator. So this is swing high, automatically we got it, previous high. So what is the target for this breakout? Go to Fibonacci retracement, and then here, from here plot, and the swing low. The swing low you plot here. So we got 1.618%, 24,531. The next target will be, once we sustain above this, 26,672 will be the target. So there is a chance that it can go, very less chance that it will go 26,600. In this current up move itself, it has to see some correction, make some swing low, and then because the technical thing is there, we have to retest the breakout. So 23173 was the breakout level. So we need to retest this level before going for any breakout. Okay, so 23,000 we should see before going anywhere else. Coming to the Nifty also, same way. This is a small swing here. Let us see what is the breakout level for this. The smaller swing, we got 1.68% here. Then 12,000 is the next target here. If we, that will be less chance here to reach this level. I am not expecting this to come now itself, because we, too much of price has gone up without any correction. Expecting that some big correction should come in the month of October, possible. October month is known for crash. So September also will make like this movements in the bullish mood only, so that everybody will be entering the market expecting that the market is now going to cross the previous high, and everybody will forget all the problem whatever is there, and suddenly some news will come and that taking the market down, because 2020 is not going to be so easy for market to test previous day high for Indian markets, because Nasdaq already gone, but every market is decoupled nowadays, because Nasdaq has gone super high above the previous 2 week high, but Dow Jones is not yet crossed. So we have to be watchful about that. So let us go back to our presentation, the key data points. So coming to the PCR is bullish for Nifty Bank Nifty above 1.35 1.58. India VIX has gone to 18 levels now. The highest open interest is 11,500 and 12,000 in the upper side. So yesterday itself we got indication that the highest open interest is 25,000 levels. You saw what happened here, because the call rates were not comfortable shorting 24,000 calls. Now the highest open interest for put is 23,500 puts. They are not coming 24,000. So 23,500, 25,000 is the levels. Any rise on Monday, 25,000 calls will be shorted, because these people are not afraid of the move below beyond 25,000 for this expiry. That is the reason. If these people try to square off their call options, then only something can see for another up move. So 25,000 should be the resistance for this week expiry. And future, we saw here FIIs have 74,000 contracts long positions, and the clients are trapped with 30,000 contracts of shorts. And the beauty is that all the market participants other than FIIs are short now. Clients 30,000 contracts, DAs 20,000 contracts, proprietary traders is 18,000 contracts, and only FIIs are driving the market now. FIIs are driving market on the upside and on the downside. Everybody tells that DAs has all the money power to pull the market downside or upside. Now we don't be depend on the FIIs, but see how the really FIIs are making the market go on the upside and downside on crucial times. So it is not that media tells about DA power everything, but everything is not acceptable. Only FIIs are driving the markets at all times. So the new Lakshman Rekha I mentioned here already. So we got 60 points above the Lakshman Rekha for September series already, and for Bank Nifty 700 points. So anything below this Lakshman Rekha only, you look for shorting opportunity. Otherwise, don't go in hurry to short currently. And use the simple rule. I'm just telling again you the power of 2, 20 minimally for intraday, above this bullish, below this bearish. Okay, only we cross below the McGinley 20, you look for shorting the call options. That the strike price where McGinley is there. That is very, very profitable. Just today also you see here how that have been helped you. And coming to the IV, the put option, because the market has gone so much here, the people are buying put options expecting the market will come down. So everybody will be trapped on Monday also. Again, the market will start moving up in the beginning, because normally if your market want to come down, first it will go up, then only it will come down. So there is a high chance that the market will open gap up again on Monday, and then only will come down, okay, to trap all these puts, because they will believe the market will come down on Monday and they will be trapped, then they exit the position, then only the market will come down. And for Monday, these are levels you have to see. 24,100 is the level midpoint. If you open above this, then be bullish. There is only 15% chance that it will go below 24,000. So there is less chance that considering the current close, there is less chance that we will open below this level. And here also the same way, Nifty opening above the midpoint is a high chance, unless there is some bad news comes, anything which is not expected. And coming to the moving averages, we have very good support at 11,300 for Nifty. Before that, we have good support here in Lakshman Rekha. So Lakshman Rekha, 11,600 in futures, just keep a tab. Below that only, you have to be bearish. And for Bank Nifty, 200 moving average around 25,000 levels. So there is high chance that we will test 25,000 levels. We are not much far actually, just 600 points away from 200 moving average. Media will do all the necessary action to touch this 200 moving average. They will put some ticker also, how many points to reach 200 moving average. They will put a ticker and all immediately the traders will get panic and start pushing the price towards 200 moving average. So this is what normally happens in the market. You remember when the market touched 12,000 also, everything was doing, and the media does like that, that how many points to 12,000, they ensure that the market reaches 12,000. So that's the way they do, and once they start doing something like that, rest assured that they will do the needful for touching the 25,000 levels for Bank Nifty without any difficulty. Coming to the long breakout levels, 25,000 level is a long breakout. There is less chance of 25,000 above because we, as we saw, the market is at 10.1% above 20 moving average. So there is less chance that we will test 25,000 at least for Monday. And for short breakout, 24,000 level is the short breakout. 1000 points range now almost now. If you see here, the range has increased now for long breakout and short breakout level. And this short breakout for Bank Nifty is 11,600 level roughly. And here for long breakout, 11,700 level for Nifty. So here also almost 100 points. Here 100 points gap and here 1000 points gap for Bank Nifty. Okay. So coming to the learning time, so today I want to show you something like for new people, okay, somebody who want to do paper trading, how they can do paper trading, what is the best option, I just want to show you something. If some, maybe somebody is aware already, maybe somebody is not aware, they can try. For example, if there are somebody who friends or somebody new, like children, they want to try, if you are interested in the market, they can try this. So the website you can see, even many of them, you know, Sensible. papertrade.sensible.com is the website. You go there, you have to log in using your Zerodha or any other broker listed here, Alias Blue or Whomsoever, and then you have to connect with a Google account also. They need both. So once you create, you get something like this, a portfolio. So you can tell here create portfolio, then you can take here FNO. If you want to try FNO, you can tell FNO create. Once you tell create, then you click and go inside, then you can create a strategy. Tell here new strategy, add new strategy. You can tell here bullish, tell here, tell bullish, add strategy. Okay, now once you add the strategy, you can edit. Okay, edit bullish, update. Now I want to add an order. For example, I want to add an order. You can tell here, I want to buy call option. Okay, now Nifty call option, I want to buy, say 11,600 call option, one lot, I want to buy, add. I can tell add. So you are getting the position here. Once the market opens, it will get updated here. So this is the option Greeks also, you get here updated automatically. What is the delta, vega, gamma, theta? Analyze, you tell analyze here, you will get analysis for the position what you have here. So this is 7-day trial, I believe. After that, you have to pay, and if you are interested, you can try that actually. So this is the strategy they are telling here. Like how the market, when the price at this year, which price you are going to be profitable, what is the projected loss. It's a very good website actually. If you are feeling worth it, then you can see the price also here they mention. And if you want to try other strategies, you can try the other strategy also. Add a virtual trade, you can try all the options. What is the bearish strategies, what is the neutral strategy, other strategies you can try here. Long strangle, iron counter, iron butterfly, so many things you can try. With different experience, you can try your own, try in different experience or month end experience. You can try that also. Okay, hope I think you like this video. Please subscribe, like this channel. So hope you enjoy this video. Thank you so much.